Okay, so this is part two of Lori and Chad Daybell. So in the last video, we left off on early 2019, but I do want to just go back because I forgot to mention that in 2018, November 26th, 2018, Lori and Chad appeared together on a podcast called Time to Warrior Up, made by Preparing a People, that conference that they met at, and it is with Jason Mao and Melanie Gibb. If you would like to listen to that podcast, I will have a video posted on that in my YouTube or on my YouTube channel. And again, that link is in my bio. Please subscribe to my YouTube because I will be going over this whole case in much, much more detail. And I do just want to remind you that we're just hitting key bullet points right now, and there are a lot of intricacies into everything that I am talking about right now that I will be going into greater detail on in future videos and on my YouTube channel. And I will be going live very often to talk about this, but because TikTok decided to permanently ban my live access on this page, please follow my backup page and I will tag that backup page here in the bio or in the description of this video so that you guys can just easily follow it. That's really where you guys can watch these videos and then come into the live and ask me questions and I can elaborate more on this. Okay, so let's go back to early 2019. Very early 2019, January to be exact. January 29th, 2019, Lori calls her husband Charles and tells him that she is a god sent to carry out the work of the 144,000 at Christ's return and his second coming, and if he got in the way, that she would unalive him. On January 30th, Charles goes on a business trip to Texas, and Lori also calls him again and tells him that she is getting rid of all of his stuff out of the house because he is not Charles anymore, and he is somebody called Ned Snyder. We'll get more into this in a later video when we go deep into the Charles saga. And then she also threatens to unalive him again. She doesn't just threaten to unalive him, though. She threatens to ruin him financially, and this proves to be true because on January 28th and 29th, Lori makes three bank transfers of $35,000 total from Charles's bank account, his business bank account, into their joint bank account, and then into an unknown bank account. On January 31st, when Charles was coming home, he got to the airport in Texas and he tried to get on the plane, but the airline told him that his ticket had been canceled and it was canceled by Lori. So Charles was forced to buy a last-minute $600 ticket from Texas to Phoenix. And once he landed in Phoenix, he went to go where his truck was parked and it was gone. Lori had taken the spare key and given it to her brother and told her brother to go get Charles's truck from the airport and basically left him stranded. So he took a taxi to Mesa and a friend picked him up there and brought him home. This is where Charles calls the police and tells them all about this and that he's worried for Lori. Charles also this same night files to have Lori committed. I will show you guys the body cam footage and all of that. I'm gonna try and do it here, but definitely on YouTube, and we'll go through this whole thing. I'm just scratching the surface. In February 2019, Charles files for divorce from Lori and they separate. Charles moves back to Texas and Lori stays in Arizona. Now, Lori moves into a new house with her daughter Tylee, and her son JJ. July 11th, 2019, Charles is in town and he goes to pick up JJ to bring him to school, and this is where Charles's death happens in Lori's new home at the hands of her brother Alex. Again, we are going to get into those details at a later date. After that whole saga takes place, Lori moves to Rucksburg, Idaho, where Chad Daybell lives. September 8th, 2019, the last photo of Tylee, Lori's daughter, is taken at Yellowstone. Lori, Tylee, JJ, and Lori's brother Alex had all gone there. September 9th, 2019, Alex's phone pings in Chad Daybell's backyard for 2 hours. That same day, Chad sends his wife, Tammy, a text message saying that there was a large raccoon in the backyard and that he took care of it and it is now buried in their pet cemetery. September 22nd is the last time that JJ was seen. And on September 23rd, Alex's phone again pings in Chad Daybell's backyard, but for this time only for 17 minutes. On October 7th, a wedding ring was delivered to Alex Cox, Lori's brother's apartment. When they moved to Rucksburg, Alex also moved with Lori to Rucksburg, and they got apartments in the same apartment complex. On October 9th, Tammy Daybell, Chad's wife, is returning home and she's confronted by an intruder that tries to shoot her and does miss. And when she yells for Chad, he comes running around the corner and has a very weird exchange with the intruder and kind of is like talking to him instead of freaking out. And on October 19th, Tammy Daybell is found dead in her home, apparently of natural causes. About 2 weeks later, on November 5th, Lori and Chad go to Hawaii and are married on the beach. In the wedding photos, you can see that Lori is wearing that wedding ring that was delivered in October, on October 7th, and Tammy didn't die until October 19th. And at this point, nobody has seen the children. Her children had been missing for over a month and a half at this point, almost 2 months. On November 26th, the police go to do a welfare check on JJ because Kay, JJ's grandmother, had not heard from him in months and repeatedly tried to get in touch with Lori but couldn't, so she called the police. This is where we find out about the ring because Kay, Charles's sister, was able to get into his email and saw that they used Charles's Amazon account to order this ring. And so that's where they got the address to where Lori was and subsequently where they could send the Rucksburg police to do the welfare check. They didn't find JJ, but they did find Alex Cox and Chad Daybell at Alex's apartment, and Lori was at her apartment. I think technically the apartment was rented under her niece Melanie's name, who also moved to Rucksburg with them. She'll become relevant in a little bit. During this encounter, Lori tells them that JJ is with her friend Melanie, but when they ask Chad and Alex about where JJ is first, they say that he is with his grandmother Kay, and the police said that that's highly unlikely because she is the one that sent them there. So when Lori gives the story about JJ being with Melanie, they try and call Melanie, but Melanie doesn't answer, and Lori tells them it's because they were going to a movie. So the police tell Lori to try and get in touch with Melanie Gibb and to have Melanie call them, and she agrees. So Melanie does call the police, but Melanie calls the police to tell them that JJ was not with her. And so that prompted them to get a search warrant, and the next day they go to the apartments with the search warrant to search them. But when they got there, everything was gone and everybody's apartment was empty. On December 1st, Lori and Chad travel back to Hawaii and are kind of like lost track of. And this is where we're going to go to a part 3.